Good morning, happy day one. Housekeeping, if you saw something scheduled or you see something scheduled at the same time every day for this program, just disregard it. It's literally blocked out on my calendar so that I can dedicate this time to this program. I would consider doing a live or something along those lines if that's something that you're interested in. So we can discuss that if you want to post it in the comments. But just, I apologize if there was any confusion on that. But without further ado, let's address some things on day one. Okay, very clear on the program. Liquid breakfast, liquid dinner, solid meal for lunch, eat from the yes list, don't eat from the no list. Okay, so my liquid breakfast this morning is gonna be green drink. You can find that recipe. It's actually linked right on my schedule, my website. And I can screenshot it and post it here too. And then my dinner is going to be my creamy mushroom soup, which is also on my website, and it might be in this group too, I'm not quite sure. So that's my breakfast and dinner. A lot of times at dinner, I'll have like not anything chewy. You can do something as easy as like bone broth with miso paste and maybe throw some carrots in there or whatever for either breakfast or dinner. But it doesn't have to be complicated, okay? So, but get prepared. So when I make my creamy mushroom soup, I'm gonna make enough for at least 2 days. I don't wanna make it a huge batch because I get sick of eating the same thing and then I get kind of annoyed and irritated. But if I keep it fresh, I tend to really enjoy the foods that I eat and especially my liquid meals, okay? My solid meal today, it's looking like it's probably gonna be something with spaghetti squash because that's what I got on hand. I haven't really, as I mentioned yesterday, I had time to grocery shop and I found this in my pantry. I don't know if you can see this here. Okay, this brand Primal Kitchen typically does a good job. This one does not have eggs in it. A lot of their products do have eggs in it. So just be mindful with their with anything you buy from them. But I typically like them. They do have a vegan mayonnaise that you can use and that I find tends to help create creamy sauces and all that, but I don't have time for that today. So I will probably put some chicken and a bunch of veggies and make some Alfredo using that sauce because I need something quick. Now, as far as the coffee sitch, this is what I recommend. And I'm really gonna strongly encourage you to not drink coffee on this, like during this program. And if you saw my comments on a post by Alana yesterday, you'll understand why, okay? Because when you get a jolt of caffeine like that, you are like pumping cortisol through you. And what it does to your adrenal glands is it tends to have an adverse effect because your adrenal glands kick in a fight or flight situation, like I'm being chased by a bear or I'm being chased by a mountain lion or whatever. And so you get this like spike of cortisol, but not only, you know, cortisol just gets a bad rap. It's actually a pretty good thing. It's what gets you out of bed in the morning, or it can be good. My issue is that when you disrupt an endocrine hormone like that, you have a cascade of disruption in your entire endocrine system. Therefore, if you are looking to balance hormones, are addressing like insulin resistance or blood sugar issues or having trouble losing weight or issues with sleep or anything along those lines, I'm gonna really strongly encourage you to drink coffee because that could be, it could be the cortisol piece and it could also be some gut stuff. You know, often when people plateau with things like weight loss or have like the make or break. So Dandy Blend. You could also use, it's just dandelion tea. And what I typically do is throw a handful of cashews in the blender, just a small, and blend my tea. Sometimes I use collagen as well, which I don't have here, but I can show you. I'll post a picture of it. Last thing I want to talk about is supporting digestion, because remember, this is all about restoring the integrity of your gut. So I'm not a huge supplement taker, but I do take supplements as needed. If you have a hard time with acid reflux, zinc could be really beneficial because it's a precursor for the creation of hydrochloric acid in your stomach. Often, if you don't have enough HCl, that gives you acid reflux. And a multi-mineral gives you all the cofactors for digestion. But I'm out of time for this video. More to come.